Well, it's a difficult question you ask, because while you elect the Board of County Commissioners and you elect us to make those funding decisions, you also elect the Board of Education. And so, and they are accountable to you just like we are. So it's not a question of us imposing our views on the Board of Education. And so I think it has to be, we have to have respect for the people who you elected to run our educational system. Yes, we can put, we can have influential conversations with them about it. We can, but there's very limited ability to use our funding to do that. We've tried that in the past when we, for example, put money in contingency for to go to teacher raises because we wanted the school board to do that and not renege on that promise. But I don't know that we can do that at the really base level that you're talking about, because we don't have that legal authority.
Dr. Filoki, I think that the citizens of Mecklenburg County has more, you have more authority and more pressure you can put on the school board than the county commission. Because the county commission, I mean, yeah, that's right. The county commission does not have judiciary power to fund education, the state does. And so since it goes, however, if you're asking specific questions, if I knew what they were, I might be able to address them. However, I will tell you this. We cannot sway the school board to do anything.
I would start off by talking about respect, that I believe we need to respect them, and they need to respect us. And I do believe that we do have trust issues. We certainly have trust issues on the current board among ourselves, and we have trust issues with CMS. I do believe we need to talk to them more frequently. I know I can certainly say that when I led the board, when we had our meetings with them, we all sat together, and they were, you know, felt a partnership. But this year, I thought they were disrespected when they were not allowed to sit with us. And they certainly told me that they didn't feel respected. I do believe also, I mean, I need to go to more school board meetings. I do watch them on television, but I need to go more. And but I do believe we need to talk to each other more frequently so that we can try to work things out. And this is our community, and I think that they could probably give suggestions to us and we could give suggestions to them. But until we meet with them and talk to them regularly, I think it's always going to be a problem.
I don't really have much unique to offer here. I would like to say, of course, that I don't think that strings can be attached to the monies that we get at CMS. I do think that, to echo what Commissioner Cotham stated, communication is key. I have already been meeting with school board members to find out how they can best be supported. I've also been meeting with Dr. Zuyus and Dr. Morrison because I want to know what they need and how they can be supported. So, again, I echo what they said.
Trevor, put on your hat. I fully agree with you. Unfortunately, we can't tell the school board to do anything. We do not have the authority to go over there and tell them what they can and cannot do. And furthermore, doing that would just be counterproductive anyways, because if we anger all of them, they're not going to do what we ask anyway. So we have to work with them. I've been cultivating relationships with many of the different school board members. So we can go over and politely suggest, hey, we'd like to see this happen. Now, we can earmark funds. We can, you know, make that happen. But it's preferred if we don't do that, so because they're their own entity and have to be able to make their own decisions. And they are an elected body. I mean, the people of Mecklenburg County choose them. So we should respect that autonomy.
If I understand your question right, about who actually goes out the money. Now, it used to be that the county was in the business of doing that. We got out of that business, and that's why the ASC, the Arts and Sciences Council, exists in part, because we got out of it, the city got out of it, so now the Arts and Sciences Council primarily does the funding. And I think it was a good decision for us to get out of it. Part of the referendum is to help provide more funding to the Arts and Sciences Council.
Right.
Because we believe that it needs to be a public-private partnership to support our arts and cultural sector. Did you know that the two reasons that companies actually move to Mecklenburg County is our educational system and our arts and cultural sector?
15 seconds.
So we do need to fund it. But again, I'm a little bit leery about getting back in the business of deciding who gets what funding. We can put pressure, perhaps. We can engage with the Arts and Sciences Council, but I'm not sure we should get back in that business.
Again, I guess number one, the county council is not doing it. But if you ask me a specific problem of whatever you have, something you're interested in, some of us, as Trevor said, use our bully pulpit and talk with the folks on the Arts and Science Council. But other than that, we can't give them something and try to also do what they do, right?
Right. Okay. I believe that we need to stay engaged with them, and we need to be on top of it. I know when I was leading the board, when they came to ask for money, I did ask them to tell us the salaries of the top executives, and they did do that. So I think we need to hold them accountable, but we have to be involved. I mean, the chairman of the board is usually on the Arts and Science Council, so I was, and now Trevor is. So there are opportunities to ask, and also to put pressure on them. I've been on the education board of the Blumenthal for about 13 or 14 years. I'm the longest serving. They've asked me to stay on that. I'm the longest serving person. And because I stay engaged and I keep pressuring them to be involved with the schools and with our community. And we have to keep pressuring them because I don't think that we bring enough of the arts out into the community. And so that's something that we need to. And I mean, I have talked to the Arts and Science Council about having music sometimes at the bus station, at the transit center, or even bringing it to the jail, because music brings joy. So I think that is important, but it's what, you know, what you put into it is what you get out of it.
From what I recall, City of Charlotte gives about $3.5 million a year to Arts and Science Council. They increased in their budget $500,000 this past year. Mecklenburg County, the county gives $200,000 to $300,000, and that's down from originally about 5 years ago, they were giving $600,000 a year. So the county has dropped in funding. I do think we need to find money. And I think I've given a concrete example of some waste that we have, that we can take that waste and put it to important arts and science, which is very important to our children and to our community. And just to rebut one issue, I do think that businesses, Mecklenburg County won't even make it on the short list if our tax rate is too high. But then, in fact, if we do have quality arts and education, they're going to come here.
Did
you understand my question?
Yes, I did now. Yeah. Sorry, after I heard everybody else kind of answer it, I was trying to see where you were going with that. Growing up, I actually didn't play a whole lot of sports, believe it or not. One of seven boys, I was running my family. So I actually, my outlets were theater and debate and things of that nature and the performing arts, and I always enjoyed that. Unfortunately, the Arts and Science Council, we can't tell them what to do. So this is kind of almost a see the previous answer kind of a situation. We can put pressure on them. We can use our bully pulpit. We can ask them that they need to do this. But we can't do a whole lot more than that. So I would like to see it expand, but it's really up to them.
So it's a portfolio management issue, pretty much.
It is, and yes, absolutely.
Well, that's why I think the referendum is, and understand that we came to the referendum only after we had tried everything else to persuade the legislature that the path that they're on in cutting funding to education is a dangerous path for the whole state, certainly for Mecklenburg. And so we, looking at that, said, look, are we just going to wave our hands in the air and just hope that the legislature will get it, or are we going to do something for ourselves? And what we came to the conclusion was we need to fend for our own people. We need to fend for our own teachers. We hope that by doing this, that the state will see that we are serious about education, that we are serious about providing proper funding. It should be the state. We shouldn't even be in this business. But insofar as they're not doing it, we can't just sit here and do nothing.
Well, the point of sales is where the taxes come from, and I think Mecklenburg County has the largest point of sales, let me tell you. So we need to use our bully pulpit, that means every last one of us, when we are electing people to go to Raleigh, to ensure that they know that we need to bring those fundings back here. They get more, right now, the state get more money from Mecklenburg County, and they get to play with it. That we need to put education number one, and we need to say that Mecklenburg County comes first.
I believe we need a serious community conversation, a serious one, a long one, because I said about the referendum, I didn't know if it was the right thing or not, because we didn't really discuss it. And I think that it's going to take the school board, it's going to take educators, it's going to take citizens to sit down and really evaluate what do we want. And then that's how we're going to get more support. And we also have to get people to vote. Because the reason we're in the situation is because in 2010, a lot of Democrats didn't vote. So there's a lot that can be done in Raleigh. There's a lot that can be done here. We certainly have our teachers make more money than in other parts of the state. But, you know, we need to step up as a community and have a serious conversation and evaluate everything and do what's right for our teachers. So I think that's how we're going to make a change, because then we're going to get more people, more input of it. But I look forward to it.
I do believe that, well, the Constitution states that school funding is primarily a responsibility of the state. I am pleased that there was improvement in teacher salaries this year. And, you know, we've had 10 years of decline, and at this point we've had some improvement, 5% on average. I will say I'm not pleased that it was the younger teachers that were giving the most raises. My daughter's favorite teacher is from 5th grade at Myers Park Traditional, both of them, and they go back to see Susan Laney. Susan Laney has taught for 31 years. And she gave me an earful, and I was happy to listen and not happy to talk about it, but she got 0.3% increase. I have continued to talk to state legislatures that they've got to continue working. They're not done. They've assured me they're not finished. And so we're making movement in the right direction, but I continue on it. I want to continue to advocate for teachers.
Thank you for the question. At the end of the day, it really is a state issue. It's part of the state constitution that is the funding. That they are responsible for funding education. I think they've done a decent job with putting the money, but I get hinky on the how they wanted to do it with 5% more in the beginning and less in the end. I get a little weird about that. I choose my words very carefully, and when I said earlier that I do not support the tax referendum, what I mean is if the tax referendum were to be voted on and passed, and I were to also be elected, I would make sure that the entire time I was there, that money always went exactly where it was supposed to go, at the level it's supposed to go. The difference between opposing and not supporting is if I opposed it, I'd pull a Bill James and just yank the money somewhere else. I would absolutely not do that. I think that money is very important to go to the teachers if it passes. And that's why it's on the ballot, and that's why everyone's going to have to vote and decide on it.